ready as I can be.
And we're rolling! 3, 2, 1!
And we're live. How would you like your haircut?
Make me beautiful.
You got it.
But after a couple of weeks, it always turns out like this anyways.
Yeah, it's true, actually. It's kind of... It grew out nice.
I feel like it didn't grow as much this time.
No?
No. Maybe it was a shorter cut because of Florida, but...
You went to Florida for Easter. How was that?
Yes, I did. It was nice. Davin and her kids ended up showing up. My mom went down, too. So it was pretty fun.
That's good.
I had to take my mom to the hospital.
That's not fun.
So she slipped at the pool and busted her shin open.
What happened? What'd they do?
Something about Rio getting Devin's kid out of the pool. Yeah. The kids are drinking way too much.
So there was lots of blood.
Yeah.
So did she get stitches?
Nope.
Really?
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised.
What'd they do then?
Just gave her antibiotics.
Okay.
We waited a day to go to the hospital. When she first did it, I cleaned it up and looked at it. It didn't look that bad.
Uh-huh.
Then the second day when I re-cleaned it, and I was like, yeah, you should probably go to the hospital. I thought they would glue it shut at least. It was a good gouge.
They glue wounds now instead of stitches?
Yeah, sometimes.
Well, that seems less painful.
Yep.
Than having to get, what do they call it, sutures? Is that the medical term?
Some people have staples. They don't even do glue or stitches. It's staples.
I don't know.
That seems scary.
Have you had both? I know you've had.
No, I've had none of them.
You've never had stitches?
Never, no.
What?
Yeah.
Why do I find that so hard to believe? You ever break a bone?
Yeah. Broke a rib, collarbone. All my fingers.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I've known you a long time. I've known you've broken a few things.
I've come pretty close to needing stitches. At least I have super glued cuts closed before.
You did it yourself, or?
Yeah.
With what, Gorilla Glue?
Super glue, yeah. Oh. I don't think Gorilla Glue was around at the time. It's been a long time since I've had a bad cut.
This is for you.
Thank you.
That's wood.
Now that I'm not working on cars as much, my...
Yeah.
Definitely haven't had as many cuts as I normally would.
That makes sense. Okay, so you ready for the topic?
Yeah.
You might not even have any, but I hope you do. So today's podcast, I'm having a guy come later, and we pre-thought this, what to say. Well, he has. I don't really have any good stories. The topic is worst dates you've ever been on. Have you ever had like a messed up first date?
No, not really.
Really?
Yeah. I guess I'm like so chiller that I could care less, you know? So.
Or just dating like crazy girls. Crazy dates.
I like crazy girls.
Or yeah, guys.
I don't know about dates though. So I haven't dated in a long time, so...
This is true.
I mean... Yeah. Jeez, yeah, no, I can't even think of, like, a date.
No.
Nope.
Or a crazy event.
Well, yeah, I don't know.
I know when
those are abundant.
Yeah, right. But when I think of, like, the worst date you've ever been at, I would think it would be, like, first date, like, all the red flags. I've been on some bad dates, but with people I was dating.
Yeah.
If they got too drunk, they fell asleep in the car or something stupid, you know.
Yeah, I'm pretty good at avoiding crazy confrontations, so I don't have, like, girls throwing shit at me or stuff going sideways, you know.
I heard this one story where this girl was was going out with this guy, and he said he was going to take her out for burgers. And on the way to pick her up, he asked for gas money. And then he took her to McDonald's. I've had a guy ask me for gas money before. But that was, like, back in the day when we were, like, kids, you know.
High school.
Like, yeah. Which...
a little bit more understandable.
That is. Because I had asked Will about it. I said, what's the worst date you've ever been on? So we can have these stories for the podcast later. He's like, You know, actually, no. You know what he said? I've never been on another date besides you. Well, your two baby mamas say different. Yeah. It was so funny. I was like, no, for real.
I said, me and Raquel didn't go on dates till after the kid, basically.
Really?
Yeah. You know, well, we were trying to hide it behind Devin's back or whatever at the time. So. Yeah.
How long did, because Raquel was Devin's friend first, right?
Yep.
How long did you guys date until she found out that you guys were dating?
Probably like 6 months.
Oh, wow. Yeah. She never had an inkling or, like, knew that you guys were dating?
No, not really. No.
You're a good hider. Whoa. Now, you and Devin are Irish twins, right?
Yep.
That means that you're, for, like, a little bit, you guys are the exact same age?
Yep. I would say, for Irish, I don't know about. I know we're somewhat twins. Not identical twins, but yeah.
Yeah, because you're, what, 11 months apart?
Yep.
Yeah, so not a good topic with you, then.
No, not really. We've had crazy times hooking up with girls.
Really?
Yeah, but I've never said really gone on dates.
Well, that's a date, so. Hooking up.
Sure. That's one of the best ones, is going to a party, and this is just a house party with a bunch of people, friends from work, whatever, and, you know, and some girl, one of the girls there, the friend's boyfriend invited me out, he wanted to go get high, so hop in this car to go get high with, you know, just two or three girls.
And, you were the only guy?
Yep.
Okay.
So hop in this car, and they have to go in their friend's house, where there's like another four or five girls. So I end up at this house. At Christmas, like a couple days before Christmas, with like eight girls, and we're all smoking, drinking, and hanging out. And like, basically at 12 o'clock, you know, nothing was like, we weren't going back to the other party at this point.
Okay.
So the girl I was there with her boyfriend ended up basically passing out in my lap, and I ended up.
Wait, the girl's boyfriend passed out in your lap?
Yep.
The dude did?
She did. The girl, not the guy.
So, yeah.
So, dude's girlfriend passed out on my lap.
And you're friends with the dude.
I went with, worked with him.
Okay.
And, so, you know, she passes out, whatever. She's the one I went there with. Well, I end up talking, bullshitting. Like, 1 o'clock, the one girl has to go back to get her car. So, three of us end up hopping back in the car. And going back, well, the other two girls came back to my Jeep, and we ended up screwing around in the Jeep for a while.
You and two girls or three girls?
Two girls. So one girl ended up going, taking her car and ended up leaving. So yeah, the one girl with the boyfriend, and, oh my gosh, what was her name?
Don't say any names.
Okay.
That's, no names. Candy.
Yeah. But she was Muslim.
Oh, no. Yeah.
So.
That's haram.
No, no. Pakistani or something like that.
No, haram means, like, that's bad. You can't do that. Haram is, like, bad.
Oh, she wasn't supposed to.
Yeah.
I don't know if she was Muslim, but I assume so.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, I remember her name now.
Yeah.
So.
So, Candy.
So, yeah. So, that was a crazy moment, you know.
So then what happened when you went back to work and then the girl's boyfriend's there that you just...
Well, like I said, I just went to a party with her and, yeah, so
You didn't tell him?
Nope. I didn't say nothing. And they end up breaking up while we were working there. I stopped working there and ended up hooking up with her again while I was working at another one at McDermott. And got a call from her. So we were hooking up at McDermott. She ended up hooking up. We were like on and off.
You guys are just like
bumping
buddies.
At the time, I wasn't interested in dating or nothing. I wanted kids or whatever. And, you know, she's not interested.
Wait, you wanted kids?
Yeah. But you know, I'm looking for like a wife, you know.
Oh, but you weren't interested in dating?
Yeah, well, she wasn't.
Gotcha.
Gotcha. She didn't want kids. She didn't want, you know.
Gotcha.
Yeah. She's got a long relationship. She wasn't interested in that.
Yeah, with your friend.
Yeah. So this leads up to my only other crazy story is basically I've been messing around with her for, geez, years now.
Mm-hmm.
And she ended up getting back with her boyfriend. And they are now married.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, they've been married, geez, 7, 8 years now?
Dang.
Yeah, she's been screwing me the whole time.
Let me guess. She's got kids with the guy now.
Nope, no kids still. Yep, she still doesn't want kids. Okay. Yeah.
So he never knew that you guys
still doesn't know.
Wow.
The worst part, well, I've been over her house a few times. She hasn't been over to... She's been over to the Rochester house.
Okay.
She hasn't been over to my place. But yeah, 99% of the time, we're meeting at the Myers parking lot.
Meeting at Myers?
Yeah. Because
she... You go in your Jeep?
Well, not in a Jeep. Whatever car. Whoever's car works better. But yeah, every time she goes grocery shopping.
Oh.
Basically when I get the call.
Wow.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, her man's like, wow, you really take a long time grocery shopping.
Yeah, poor guy. She loves him.
Oh, I'm sure she loves him so much. Man. Yeah, I think Will's got a story like that. One person once upon a time went to Walmart to get milk and was gone for like over 4 hours.
Oh, my God.
And then came home without milk. I drank it all on the way home and threw it out the window. Like, come on. You gotta have a better alibi than that.
Yeah, after RD, she always goes in and does her grocery shopping.
So wait, the parking lot?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're lucky you never got caught.
Guess.
By, like, another, like, mom in a minivan driving with.
I've always had tinted windows, so I guess that helps.
Yeah.
Never really even thought about it till now, getting caught.
Well, I would hope now you wouldn't participate in behavior like that.
Oh, I still do.
Oh my goodness. You have a house!
Uh-huh.
You don't trust people in your house, is that
right? Oh, no, I definitely.
That's actually kind of smart.
No, I got one girl I see occasionally, too. I'd be willing to bring her over, but she's got kids, so most of the time we're at her house just because she doesn't have a babysitter or nothing.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good one. He can never... But you don't hook up with that girl still, right?
Yeah, I still do.
She's married?
Oh, yeah.
Daryl!
Last time I seen her was in February.
So she's going grocery shopping now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, no names.
Every couple months, yeah.
So she's, but you said she loves her husband?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you don't love him if you don't respect him. Or she loves him if she don't respect him. I don't know. Dang. That's pretty bad.
Yeah, so that's the only interesting, crazy story I really got.
That's pretty good. That's totally off the topic of worst dates you've ever been on, but that's.
I wish I had a worst date.
That's some juicy gossip right there. Holy crap. You adulterer. Is that what it's called? She's the adulterer.
Yeah, I said I'm single. I don't think there's any issues here with me.
Yeah, because, I mean, it's bad on both your parts.
That's pretty bad.
But Will said one time, I think it was when we first started dating, We were together like maybe 3 months, and he gave me a ring. He was like, boom, put this on your finger. I said, wow, you really want to make sure no guy's like going to, you know, question if I'm on the market or not. And he says, honestly, a lot of guys, he didn't say most men, but he said a lot of guys would see that and be like, well, hell yeah, I can just do what I want and throw you back to your husband after I'm done.
Yeah, I guess.
I'm like, that's one way to think about it. But people still, like, I wear a ring on both hands, and I'm at the gym, and I got this guy that's always following me around. And, like in a creepy way, though. And he's always trying to talk to me, and I'm like, I'm doing this. I'm very married. I don't understand. So I told Will, I was like, I'm trying to avoid this guy. He keeps following me around. If I go to a machine, he goes to a machine. He's got to, like... He doesn't really, like, engage in conversation, but
yeah,
he's...
that's weird.
He's always, like, has to be... If I'm on the stair climber, he's on the machine right behind me. If I'm on a machine, he's on the machine right in front of me. And then he'll make, like, one-liners, like, hey, or...
Just hey. Not even a line. Just one-words.
One-words. Hey. Or he'll say, like, it's worth it, isn't it? Because, you know, working out. And then one time I jumped off the stair climber. He's like, I love when you dismount. I was like, whoa. Whoa, bro. You are overstepping in the boundary.
I can't believe you didn't yell and scream on, what the fuck you thinking? Mary, leave me the fuck alone.
No.
I could see you.
Yeah, I mean, if it, like, really, I mean, if somebody were to, like, touch me or something, but, like, no, I mean, I just see him all the time. And so Will told me, he's like, instead of trying to avoid him, because that's what I was doing, and then I just would ignore him or whatever, like, not look at him when he's looking at me, he's like, let him talk to you. He's like, obviously, he's like, he wants to talk to you, so let him talk to you and just be like, I'm married. Well, so you know what? Why didn't I think about that?
Yeah, I say, just talk. Like I said, just say something.
Like, that's all you gotta do is say, I'm married, so.
No, that definitely doesn't work.
It doesn't?
Time. No, some guys don't care whether you're married, taken.
Oh. Yeah, clearly.
Yeah.
Whoa. I can't believe I'm just hearing about this story today. Normally I would tell you how proud I am of you, but I am not proud of you in this situation. Yeah, just... But you're no longer friends with that lady's husband, right? Since you guys stopped working together?
We just worked together, yeah. Oh, we're like, yeah, really friends.
Gotcha.
You were just co-workers.
Co-working, yeah. Acquaintances.
I fixed her car one time. And I made a beer pong for them.
Oh.
Actually, for that party.
For the party where you and the other girls...
Yeah.
But she was one of the girls that was in the double, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. So she's clearly a classy girl.
Oh, yeah. I think I'm the only other guy she's been with other than her boyfriend.
What?
Because they got together way back in high school. So, when they first started dating, they were in high school or whatever, when I was back at ABC Warehouse.
Gotcha. She never complains, like, tells you, now I want to know what's the tea with her and her husband, why has she been doing that?
She just likes the sex, I guess. That's what she said. She just enjoys the sex with me.
She's not like... He's so awful. Just like, she doesn't even talk about him. She just says, yo, I'm going grocery shopping.
Yeah, basically.
Meet me on aisle 5.
They said they were high school sweethearts or whatever. And yeah, I think basically after that night, looks like she was completely wasted or whatever. And yeah, she decided she wanted to try it with other people or whatever. And
but never told him.
No. I don't know if she might have. I think she told him, you know, she went and slept with other people while they were broken up or whatever.
Oh, so she didn't, like, really tell him.
No. Oh, yeah.
I'm stressed out now.
I haven't seen him for years and years.
But you just saw her 2 months ago? Why am I laughing? This is horrible. Daryl, I'm gonna have to give you a fake name today too. We call your name. We call her Candy. That's her name. Unless it's her real name, I'm gonna bleep that out. Okay, but don't say it, please. That won't be good.
Do you remember? Oh, no names. My sister's friend.
Mouth it to me. No.
No. She dated John. Oh, yep. Yeah, shouldn't say that either.
Okay, that's there's 18.
Yeah, no, Johns. I was gonna
the
say
one what? with the first last name.
Yeah. That one.
Oh wait, maybe I do. Was she little?
Yeah, she had Pierce. Anyways, I tried getting with her sister back when I was like 16.
Okay.
And her sister was a stripper, and yep, just kind of.
Did it work?
Keep saying Candy. No, oh no.
Oh, that reminds you of Candy.
Yeah, I just.
I have a wig named Candy.
As being like 16 years old, driving a stripper around.
Oh. Why do I feel like I remember that? Whoa. Yeah. Maybe I do.
I got a lot of drugs from it. So.
From the stripper?
Yeah.
I feel like I remember that.
Yeah.
Or that was like an alleged story of the Daryl and the stripper.
Well, it was one of my sister's good friends.
But her sister was the stripper.
Yes.
Sister stripper.
Yeah. She had two sisters.
Whoa.
One sister had the same name as my sister.
Whoa. Don't remember.
No.
Maybe. I don't know. Daryl, back when we was in high school.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
It was a long time ago, and there was many of people that we met throughout. You're actually one of the few people that I still talk to that I've... like known this long. You and most of my other old friends, they all have kids now, and like I'm not, maybe if I had kids their age it would be a thing to do, but like, I don't want to go to Chuck E. Cheese on the weekends. I'm not trying to do all that.
Nope.
And like when you have kids, that's your whole world, so I mean, we still, like, keep in touch via, like, social media, but that's really it.
Yeah, I feel like I talk to you more than I talk to anybody else. Except Johnny.
Yeah.
It's here and there now.
And, well, and the same thing with him. When he became a dad, I'm sure that you probably saw him less.
When I became a dad.
Yeah, but you became a dad so young.
Yeah.
You and Will were both really young dads, but... the difference between you and Will is that you stopped at one kid. Will.
For the time being.
No one did. And here's my seat. And here's my seat. And you get a baby. Man. We only have one out of his five kids that doesn't have any kids yet. And he'll be 50 in a few months. So he became a grandpa. I was 27. He was 41. Grandpa.
His daughter was how old, or son?
She. So not even the oldest kid had the first kid. Because his oldest child is 5 years younger than me.
Okay.
Then there's Michael. He's just turned 28.
Wow.
28. And then his oldest daughter is 10 years younger than me, so she just turned 26, because I'll be 36. So she had the first baby when she was, I think, 17, maybe 18. But his whole family had kids really young. His mom was 17 when she had her first one. She was done having kids by the time she was, 20-something, early 20s. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I always worry about that with Leela.
Become a young mom. She don't got a boyfriend, does she?
Well, according to her, no.
Well, there's this thing
called... Yes, she definitely does.
Oh, she does?
I don't know now, but...
birth control.
Yeah.
But a lot of people are against birth control now.
Condoms.
You don't want to be a teen parent. if it takes away. I mean, you are the exception, honestly. Well,
I don't know. I don't want to be one. Just you do what you have to, you right. know?
But you were a good dad, too. Like, you really were with Lila. Not, I mean, you are, but she's, what, yeah. going to be 17 mm-hmm. this year? Yeah. At that age, she wants nothing to do with her parents and everything to do with her friends, you know? That's just how it goes.
Well, so I can see what she's doing online. So that's how I know she's talking to boys.
Ooh.
Right. Yeah. She's, you know, talking about giving head and stuff like that. So.
No! Too young! Can I put hairspray in it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, because I don't. Well,
yep, so I know, you know, I had to have a talk with her and all that. But she knows what, I know what she's doing online.
Oh my gosh, remember AOL Instant Messenger?
Yep.
So, we used to, like, talk on there to our friends before texting, because we yep. didn't have texting back in the day.
Yep.
But that was basically, like, texting, right?
Yeah, I remember.
I missed a hair right there. So, I missed a big old
one hair.
Yeah, right. A little wing. So this one time I'm like talking to my little online boyfriend, maybe. I don't even remember yeah. who I was talking to. Stupid. Some guy from North probably. And whatever. We were having an inappropriate conversation for my age. We were both kids, but my dad walked into the room. And the computer's in the living room, right?
Yeah.
And I'm too young to realize that you can't really see it that well, you know, like my eyes were really good
right.
then, but as you get older, your eyesight's
no way
not
you
as
see
good.
What you're, yeah.
So he comes into the living room, and I'm like, I couldn't exit out of the screen, so I'm blocking, you know, the thing. And he's like, I wasn't even looking, but now that
now
you did that, just
so
made it look so bad. He's like, let me teach you something. You want to get away with stuff, don't make it obvious. Oh, but he, thank God he didn't read it. I would have been mortified. Mm-hmm. Mortified.
Well, when she was 14, she was talking to some 20-something.
I remember yeah. that. Yeah, that was scary. So,
had the cops take the computer and all that.
Yep. Did they ever get that guy? Or?
But, no, not, no idea.
Until he.
I never heard nothing about it.
You know what? They don't go after him unless it's like they've already done so much damage.
Right. So what they were saying is they're going to set up like a sting, right? So they were going to message him or whatever and all that. But yeah, I didn't hear nothing about it.
Nothing.
Who knows? But yeah, ever since then, she knows I check, you know, see what's
right, so you'd think she'd be a little more incognito about
yeah.
what she's, man, having a daughter's got to be so hard. As a dad, like, and as a mom, it's like you just fight with your mom, like two fucking chickens, angry with each other, annoyed, and then, I don't know, it's gotta be hard on both.
So yeah, it's all the computer and stuff, I'm trying to make sure she actually has a real boyfriend, not like an online boyfriend, you know what I mean?
Yes, yes. So is it, you think it's a real boyfriend and not some 40-year-old?
I have no idea.
Guy that's like, hey.
I see.
High school, I see.
I can see she's sending out to someone, but I don't know.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Who or what?
The internet destroyed us.
I guess.
I'm glad that I didn't have all that stuff when I was a kid. I had a guy trying to hook up with me from MySpace. MySpace.
Yeah.
I was 19, and you know, MySpace was the shit because you could have a song on there, you can make your background real cool.
Right.
And this guy was 31,
oof.
And he had a 7-year-old kid, and I was legal age, and he was like, "Let me take you out on a date. I got a boat. Let's go on the boat." And I said, "You know, I really think that you're like way too old for me, dude. Like." Really? Like, you're 31, I'm 19, so what's that age difference?
Yeah, that's
12 years?
That's only an issue for girls for the most part. Guys could care less.
Hold on, let me think. Nine. Yeah, 12 years. So I'm like, and I thought, gross. Like, obviously you're only into me for one thing. That's disgusting. You're way too old. And he's like, the age difference isn't that bad. So 12 years. And then I marry a guy that's 14 years older than me.
It's not such a big deal when you're in your 20s, 30s. Yeah.
Right. 6 years later, I'm like, mm-hmm. Okay, let's date.
Well, my cousin, he was 20-something, 22, 23, and he started dating a 17-year-old.
Ooh.
Yeah. Well, they were neighbors, whatever. They're married now and all that, but.
I mean,
friends
17...
of the family. They've known each other forever, you know.
But if you're like 22 and 15 or 14, you know, like that's a little. I mean, 17.
Weird,
yeah, it's not legal, but it's still. I mean, just want to wait.
It's legal in Michigan.
Is it?
16 years old if they have the parents' consent.
With the parents.
Yeah.
Yeah, my grandma was 16 when she got married.
Yeah, it's definitely not.
You don't have to take your shoes off when you come here, you know.
But all the rain and mud, I was like, man, it's too clean, I'm not gonna.
It is not. I still need to sweep and mop the floor, so you can totally do that. That's fine. Because hair gets stuck in socks, and we don't like that. Well, this was a great episode.
I could share something with you, at least.
I wasn't expecting that. Wow. Thanks for watching. Bye.